The next physiography division, we are going to study the peninsular plateau. In the earlier part, you have studied about the northern plain and the Himalayan region. These both I have explained in detail in the earlier part. The videos are also uploaded. Now we'll move toward the next part, the peninsular plateau. The peninsular plateau is one of the old region in the world. Not only in India, this is in the world. This region is called shield. Shield means that region which never went under the water. So this peninsular plateau is shield on the world. The African plateau and peninsular plateau, these both are shield in the world. It means these both regions never went under beneath the water. About the peninsular plateau, we will study. The peninsular plateau is divided into two parts again. The same section is divided into two parts. Central highland, this is called central highland, and the southern part is called Deccan plateau. The central highland is again divided into different divisions: Malwa plateau, Bundelkhand plateau, Bagelkhand plateau, Chota Nagpur plateau. The Deccan plateau is divided in the different part, that is the Deccan plateau, Maharashtra plateau, Karnataka plateau. This is the region of Dandakaranya plateau and Telangana plateau. About every we will study. In the eastern part, again some part you are looking. This is the extended part of the peninsular plateau. So this plateau, this part is also part of the peninsular plateau. Maybe it is not connected with the main peninsular plateau, but this is the part of the peninsular plateau. This map already you are looking in your book also. This triangular region is the peninsular plateau. First, you will see about the central highland. The central highland from the Narmada River. The Narmada River is the south of the central highland. Then Aravalli Ranges in the northwest. This complete part belongs to the central highland, and the southern is the Deccan plateau. About central highland, we will study here. The peninsular plateau's first part, it is having two broad divisions, the central highland and the Deccan plateau. About the central highland, we will study. The eastward extension of peninsular plateau are locally known as the Bundelkhand and Bagelkhand. This is the Bundelkhand and Bagelkhand, eastward part of the central highland, Bundelkhand and Bagelkhand. Then the Chota Nagpur plateau marks the further eastward extension drained by the Damodar River. In the map already I have said here, the Chota Nagpur plateau, which is having eastward of the central highland. The peninsular plateau is composed with the crystalline and igneous and metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks, the rocks which are formed from the lava. The peninsular plateau is formed due to the explosion of the lava. That is why these are formed with the igneous rocks. Not only igneous rocks, but also the metamorphic rocks are also part of this peninsular plateau. It was formed due to the breaking and drifting of the Gondwana land, and thus making of it part is oldest landmass. The drifting we have studied in the earlier part. It is formed due to the drifting of the Gondwana land. This plateau has broad and shallow valleys and rounded hills. On this plateau, different valleys are there, shallow valleys are there, and rounded hills are also here. This plateau consists of two broad divisions, that's already we have seen, the central highland and the Deccan plateau. The part of Peninsular Plateau lying to the north of the Narmada River, covering a major area of the Malwa Plateau, is known as the Central Highland. Which part is called Central Highland? We have studied. The part of Peninsular Plateau which is to the north of the Narmada River is called Malwa Plateau, Bundelkhand Plateau, and is toward the Chota Nagpur Plateau. The Vindhya Range is bounded by the Central Highlands. The Vindhya Range toward the south of the Central Highland you are looking. The southern part is covered by the Vindhya Range. This is called Vindhya Range. Central Highland on the south and the Aravallis on the northwest. These are the Aravallis. It's are on the northwest. Always remember the directions properly. Understand the directions properly. The Central Highland is covered from the south by the Vindhya Range to the north west it is Aravallis. The further westward extension gradually merges with the sandy and rocky desert of Rajasthan. This is merging toward the part of the Rajasthan which are sandy. Sandy part means covered by the sand. The flow of rivers draining this region, namely the Chambal, the Sindh, the rivers are here, the Chambal River, Sindh River, these are flowing toward the east, northeast. It means the plateau flow, the rivers flow always says us the slope of the region. This indicates the slope is having toward the northeast. The Central Highland are wider in the west. In the west, it is looking wide than the east. In the east, it is a not wide, it is a narrow. But in a west, it is the wider, wider. Are you getting my voice now? The extension of this plateau is wider in the west and narrower in the east. This part we have studied. Then about Bagelkhand, Bundelkhand, Malwa Plateau. This is also with the help of map in the earlier part we have studied. And this is the eastern part of Central Highland, which is extended which side at the Chota Nagpur Plateau. Okay, now we'll turn toward the next part of this Peninsular Plateau, that is the Deccan Plateau. The Maharashtra, where we are living, it is the part of the Deccan Plateau. So, with the structure of Deccan Plateau, you people are very known. What kind of soil is there? What kind of structure of rocks is there? These all things you are new. With the different picnics, with the trips, you understood also different parts of the Deccan Plateau. About this, we will study. The Deccan Plateau is a triangular landmass that lies to the south of the river Narmada. This is the triangular mass, landmass. Landmass means big land region. It is lying south toward the Narmada. This is the Narmada River. And from the to the south of the Narmada, the Deccan Plateau is lying. And to the north, to the Narmada, the Central Highland is lying. When explaining, you will when there is a particular question about the Peninsular Plateau, you have to explain the two divisions and the marking of the land. The Narmada River is a marking, Satpura Ranges is also marking, So these things you have to write in detail properly. The very interesting part this is, if you will study with interest, you will understand and you will get interest to learn the geography also. The Satpura range flanks its broad base in the north while the Mahadev, this is the Satpura flank, Mahadev hills. These are the hills which are shown with the broad red line. These are showing the hills, Satpura range, Mahadev hills and Kaimur hills. These are the hills which are north of the Deccan Plateau. So whenever there is a need, you have to take the India's outline map and locate this part on that map. You will understand this part practically when you will do. You have to do it, locate it practically, then you will understand very properly. By the outline map of the India, for every lesson it is needing, for every lesson differently you will use. The Deccan Plateau is higher in the west and slopes gently toward the east. Again, the rivers are here, which indicates the slope of the region. On the Deccan Plateau, the slope of rivers you are looking toward the west to east. These all rivers are draining toward east. It means this Deccan Plateau is in a high more in the west and lower in the east. With the color, the colors are indicating here. The dark color is showing high height and the low is showing, the faint is showing the low. So with the help of this river slope, river flow, you will understand the slope of the region. So the slope of the region of the Deccan Plateau is from west to east. An extension of the plateau is also visible in the northeast, locally known as a Meghalaya, Karbi along plateau and northern North Sacher. The extension you are looking of the Deccan Plateau here, Chhattisgarh, northern Sacher. This is the extension of the Deccan Plateau. It is separated by the faults of the Chota Nagpur Plateau. The Chota Nagpur Plateau separated this part from the main peninsular plateau. Three prominent hills ranges from the west to east are Garo, Khasi and Jaintia hills. In the earlier one map, I have shown about the eastward extension. In the eastern extension, the hills are here, Garo hills, Khasi hills and the Jaintia hills. In this map also you are looking, Garo, Khasi, Jaintia. These hills are separated, or this plateau region is separated from the this plateau, and due to Chota Nagpur plateau, this is separated. This is all about the peninsular plateau. Some part of this plateau is remain now. The Western Ghat and the Eastern Ghats, which borders to the peninsular plateau. First, we will see about the Western Ghat, then we will see toward the Eastern Ghat. While studying the Eastern Ghat and Western Ghat, if you will study comparatively, so you will understand very easily. The Western Ghat is a continuous. It is, you are looking, there are no many passes, very short breaks are here, you are looking. These are also not breaks, these are passes which joins the Konkan part to the peninsular plateau. But if you will look toward the Eastern Ghat is not continuous and it is having breaking. This is the erosion work of the rivers, which rivers flowing from the peninsular plateau. These rivers eroded the part of the Eastern Ghat and made these breaks here. In the height also, the height of Western Ghat is more than the Eastern Ghat. The western and eastern ghat marks the western and the eastern edge of the Deccan Plateau. Western ghat lies parallel to the west coast. It is lying to the west coast. They are continuous. Already I have said it. Borghat, Palghat, these are giving place to join, or it's are making access these coastal land toward the peninsular plateau. About the height, we will look. The Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat, comparatively, it is shown. The Western Ghat lies on the western margin of the Deccan Plateau. The Western Ghats are higher in elevation. Their average elevation is from 900 to 1600 meters. But the Eastern Ghat, the Eastern Ghats are lower in elevation in a height. Their average elevation is a 600 meters. It is 900 to 1600 meter. But the Eastern Ghats height is just average height is 600 meters. So easily you will understand which part is heighted. The Western Ghat is having continuous chain. They can be crossed through the passes only. The Eastern Ghat, the mountain chains are not continuous and are denuded, weathered or eroded by the rivers which flow into the Bay of Bengal. No major rivers has cut across them. Not major rivers cut the Western Ghat, but the Eastern Ghat is cut by the rivers Godavari, Mahanadi, Krishna and Kaveri. This is all about the Western Ghat and the Eastern Ghat. In the Western Ghat, Anaimudi is the highest peak. In the Western Ghat, Anaimudi is the highest peak. The height of this peak is given 2,695 meters. And in the Eastern Ghat, Mahendragiri is the highest peak. The height of the Mahendragiri is given 1,501 meter. So easily you will understand the Western Ghat is in the height more than the Eastern Ghat. All about the Western Ghat and the Eastern Ghat we have studied. If you have any doubt, you can write down, you can ask me afterward. After this, immediately, we are going to start to the next session, next part.